Hello and welcome again to the Friday Wrap for April 8th. I have to, pardon me, I'm actually filming this at a Starbucks out of town where I was most of Friday. I'll be back this evening, and also a little under the weather, so hopefully my voice will be okay. But in any case, last week's village event started out last Friday when I was asked to address and attend the Modern Freemasons of the World of Illinois meeting, which was held actually at the Bur Ridge Marriott. The Illinois Grand Council is actually made up of a lodge and a chapter in Southside Chicago. Now, Freemasonry has been around since the 1500s. It's a benevolent fraternal organization that I've actually had exposure to. And you might also, if you've ever been to Alexandria, Virginia, and have seen the George Washington Masonic Memorial, they've been around since the 1500s. They also have strong Christian roots, which became even more apparent when I was actually had a chance to listen to the keynote speaker, a very well-spoken, well-educated, and accomplished Reverend Walter Matthews. Chief John Madden and I also joined at the event. I was able to stay a little longer, but then pictured with their former Grand Master, Jeff Chapman, who invited me to the event, who's also a sergeant with the Chicago Police Department. There's also this week, last Saturday, I had a breakfast fundraiser with Mayor Nowaczyk out of Willow Springs. It was held at the Irish Legend on Archer Avenue. By the way, the hill that the restaurant backs up to makes it feel like you're actually in a different state. It was attended by many of his trustees and supporters, as well as judges and even State Representative Mary Flowers, from the 33rd District, which touches actually both of our villages. Mary and I ended up talking for almost 2 hours. It was amazing. Now, that would normally have been quite a feat, considering that we're polar opposites politically, but we have several mutual friends in Springfield, and many share the same, many of the similar concerns, the future of our state, as well as values, as we're both turned out to be Catholic. As far as the Village Center goes, one of the ways we're improving the way communication, collaboration with the village, with the management team over there, is to meet on a monthly basis, to exchange ideas, and to come up with some different topics, as well as updates. As far as updates, they're going to be in the next 2 weeks. They're expected to start installing more prominent wayfinding signs along Bur Ridge Parkway, as well as the construction of the fire pit and the seating area at the village green. I was able to meet this week with Christy Trabantana, the Village Center manager at Topaz. The Police Pension Board meeting actually was held on Tuesday this week. I discussed their recommendations about police pension contributions, as well as the replacement of their actuary, who recently retired. The board decided to have a special meeting to start next couple weeks to interview prospective candidates based on experience, approach, client list, reporting, and services that they provide. Also, very important this week, there was a meeting for the IDOT conducted regarding those noise barrier walls that are proposed along the north side of I-55. The IDOT representatives and consultants made a very thorough presentation, explained how the voting process works for affected residents, and held a Q&A session. They assured the 50-plus residents that the noise would not echo or bounce or carry to any noise level exceeding, because at 3 decibels, I guess, which is required for the human ear to perceive it, and that would be great to be noticed. Though they do expect traffic to increase along I-55 from the current 150 to 180,000 cars a day to 250,000 cars a day by the year 2040. Now, if the vote passes, the walls will be 12 to 16 feet tall in height, and are proposed to go start at Harvester Drive all the way down to Garfield, down by the Fink Binder equipment. That'll be made in conjunction with the new express toll lane, or ETL they call it, that they're planning on building along I-55 to get people in and out of Chicago and handle the traffic. That meeting was held, by the way, at the middle school. Now, this week also, the village board meeting is set to meet Monday night at 7 o'clock. On a personal note, I brought my daughter to the Secretary of State's Motor Vehicle Department in Lombard. This past Saturday, she came in town to get her new driver's license, which changes to horizontal when you're 21, which I still can't believe that she's 21 years old already. So, anyway, thanks for joining me. I hope you have a great weekend and week, and we'll see you again next week.